Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am explaining you the concept of tree data structure. So, before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. In this video session, I am explaining you the concept of binary tree and its representation. So friends, let's start with the content of this video. First of all, you must know the concept of binary tree. So the binary tree is a specialized version of a general tree. Why it is specialized version? Because in a binary tree, it has a special condition that each node have minimum 0 node and a maximum 2 child nodes. Minimum 0, maximum 2. It will not exceed its limits more than 2. And 2, it means binary. So that's why the name is given a binary tree. That's why it is a specialized version. As we have seen that maximum 2 children can be there to every parent node. So that's why we can typically name them as a left child and a right child, and they are helpful to identify and to recognize the child node of every parent. This is the example of a binary tree. Here you can see that this is a root node. This is the left child of root node A and the right child of root node C. In the same way, D is a left child of B, E is a right child of B, parent node B. F is a left child of parent node C, and G is a right child of parent node C. So every node is having internal node is having maximum 2 number of child nodes, and that's why it belongs to the binary tree, or we can say that this is a binary tree. Now let's move forward for the next slide, in which I am explaining you the representation of binary tree and its node. So let's start with the representation, and here what we are going to do, we are going to see the node structure. Every time to represent a binary tree will follow the node structure, where in every node it is divided into, first of all, the information part, or it will hold the information of the node, and it will hold the references to its left child and to its right child. So in the combination of all these things, you can see that the node structure will be like this. The node is divided into three parts. This one is the information or the data part. This will hold the reference or the address of the left child, and this will hold the reference or the address of the right child. And now let's see what will be the binary tree node representation with the help of programming. So whenever I want to represent a binary tree node in our program, what the things we have to take care of. So node has three parts. The first one is data part, and it will be having the data type as far as our requirement is concerned. That is, if we want to store the integer data part, then the data part will be having a data type integer. Or if you want to store the data of type character, then the data type of this data part will be of data type character, and so on. The next two parts are nothing but the references. It will hold the address of the child nodes. It means that it will hold the address of the left child as well as the right child. And the representation of the node is nothing but the combination of all these parts with the different data types, and that's why we will make use of the structure to define the user defined data type for the node, and that you will represent with the syntax like this: struct node. The three partitions are there. Let's consider data is of type integer. Left child will hold the reference, that's why a pointer, of the data type struct node, and the right child will hold the reference, that's why pointer, of the data type user defined data type structure node. So in this way, we are going to represent the binary tree node with the programming language. Now, what are the steps we suppose to follow for the creation of the node in a binary tree? So if I want to create a node, the first step is to create a node, and the creation of the node is nothing but allocation of a memory space for a node. So let's create a node. Here you can see that the node is created and the memory is also allotted for this node. Now let's move forward for the step number 2. So what is the step number 2? Step number 2 is nothing but update the data field. That is nothing but whatever the information part you supposed to assign to that node or the data field of that node that you have to assign. So here you can see that the information part is updated here. Previously I have shown it as data, but now it is holding the information that is nothing but the character type data A. Now let's move forward for the next step, step number 3, and in this step what we have to do, we have to update the reference fields by assigning the null value to the both reference field. Why we have to assign null? To indicate that this is the node and currently a single node is there in your binary tree. You can say one more thing is that if both, that is the left child or the reference of the left child and reference to the right child, if both are null, it indicates that this is the leaf node. This node will not be having any left or right child. So that's why it is a leaf node. So in this way, we can create a node of a binary tree with the help of these 3 steps. First one is to allocate a memory. Third one is assign information part. Second one is to assign information part, and third one is to assign the null value to both reference fields. Now let's see how to represent a binary tree. So this is one simple example of binary tree I have mentioned over here, and with the help of node structure if we want to represent it, so it will get represented like this. Here you can see that this is the root node, and as you can see over here, B and C are its left and right child respectively. So that's why the reference of left child will hold the reference of node B. Reference of right child will hold the reference of node C. And one more thing you must have noticed here, like that B and C are the leaf nodes. So that's why the reference to the left and right child, both the fields are null for both the nodes, to indicate that both the nodes, that is B and C, are the leaf node. So in this way we can represent a binary tree. Now let's move forward for the construction of binary tree. So for the construction of binary tree, we suppose to follow some steps, in which the first one is to create a node. How to create a node? That we have already seen over here in the same video. So after creation of the node, what we have to do as a first step, make it as a root node, because whenever you are going to construct a binary tree, first node whatever you are going to insert, you are going to create, that you have to treat as a root node, because from the root only our tree is going to start grow in the level wise. Now what will be the step number 2? So the step number 2 we'll see over here. What is the step number 2? Step number 2 is again to create a node. So I have created a node again and attach this as a left child. So here you can see that, focus over here, I am going to update the address of the node B. This is the address of the node B, and let's update the reference of a left child field, and let's assign, or let's make the logical link between a root node and its left child. Let's move forward for the step number 3, and in the step number 3 what we will do, again we will create a new node. For that the address is in assign, a memory is allotted, its information part is also assigned, and its left and right addresses, the references to the left and right child, are assigned to null as we have seen previously. And now attach this node as a right child. So here you can focus that we are going to update the reference field of this node with the reference of the node C, that is 25745, and after updating this you can see that it is forming a logical link between these two nodes. So with the help of this, what we have done, we have constructed the binary tree, and these steps you have to form, these steps you have to execute repeatedly for the construction of binary tree with more nodes. And now you can see how the constructed binary tree will look like for the same tree. So this is the simple binary tree, and the constructed binary tree will look like this. Here you can see, here you can check the links or the references to the left child as well as reference to the right child, and with the help of that we can say here that the logical links are generated from the root node to the left child and to the right child respectively. Let's see some facts about a root node of a binary tree. So very first thing that you have to keep in mind, that a tree is represented by a pointer to the topmost node in the tree, and that topmost node is called as root node of the binary tree. So while creation of a binary tree, whatever the first node you are going to create, that will treated as a root node, and if that tree is empty, it indicates that root node is null. Or other way around, we can say that if root is null, it indicates that the binary tree is empty. So in this way you have to keep in mind all the facts, and with the help of these facts you will be able to implement the binary tree very easily. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the video and content of this video, please do not forget to give the comment, and also do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel Tech Talks, and I am providing a shortcut link for the next video of this video series, and the whole video series I am providing here in the form of playlist. So thank you friends. Happy data structuring, happy learning. Thank you.